I remember immediately thinking that my life was ruined. Who does that at 16? Who has a baby at 16? I spent the afternoon crying because I kind of felt like my world was crumbling. And one of the things Ivan said really early on in that process was, we're in this together, I'm not going anywhere. So that helped, but not even one time did we have the conversation about having an abortion. It was more about the what next, because we knew the choice was very clear. It's a choice we made together to keep the child and parent. I think I was probably more scared then, knowing that we had to tell our parents, than I was even knowing that I was pregnant. I remember my mom saying, not what I had planned for you, not what we were hoping for. Let's make a plan. When you say let's, you're not alone. You're in this together. And I wish that the parents could realize what a difference their words make when a young woman has that kind of a situation. How you respond as a parent when your son or daughter says something like that. I immediately knew things were going to be okay. And so that began the planning process. I was told I couldn't stay at the school. That's probably one of the worst memories I have of the time. Pregnant girls weren't allowed because I might give someone else ideas. That rejection still stings to this day. It's not the only time I heard words like that. So my mom, being my mom, said, okay, then how does she get her GED? What does she do? And so that kind of began this journey of what it meant to finish school. And we made the decision to, even at that age, to get married. Had lots of naysayers, lots of people that probably would have encouraged me to abort because of the situation. We just stepped forward into kind of an unknown future. Ivan was like a full-time student on a baseball scholarship. We lived in this tiny little trailer. That's what married student housing looked like at Southwest Baptist University. I remember so clearly one of the staff saying, because you sinned before you got married, she's not allowed to come to chapel. And I remember thinking, but that's not what Christ would do. That's not how he would respond. We weren't really included in married couple activities because we were very different. I was different because I got pregnant. I became pretty withdrawn, you know, kind of pulled away from everybody because I felt the judgment. And I remember one of our neighbors saying, you should try this little church down the road. There was instant acceptance. And I thought, isn't that how we all should respond? And so that started a healing process for me. And it wasn't until we joined that little tiny church, little tiny Nazarene church, that I thought, I'm gonna be a mom. And that's okay. I'm excited to be a mom. I think when I was 16, I think I thought everything's over. I can't go to college. Can't have a career, can't do the things I wanted to do. And I can sit here and tell you all those things have come true. I've gone to college, I have a son and a daughter, three amazing grandbabies, and Ivan and I have been married for 43 years. I'm not ashamed that I chose that life. Did it impact my life? Oh, yeah. Did it ruin my life? No.